Hi again and welcome to Fendi Aquarium channel. Last week I started a new series where every week I'll show you how to build and maintain a reef aquarium. We started up sitting this 120 gallon and today we'll talk about Sump. Sump is a tank or container placed lower than the display tank which receives drain water from the main tank. The benefits include increasing total water volume. Water temperature and chemistry will change more slowly in larger volume of water, which make it easier to keep the system with optimal parameters. Providing a place for equipment and filtration, such as heaters, filters, and skimmers, to remain hidden so they don't disturb the clean and tidy look of their display tank. Keeping the surface of water free of contaminants, the overflow is a mechanism that drains water into the sump from the display tank. Any water that rises above a certain level in the tank overflows through the drain into the sump. This will keep constant water level in the display tank and make the surface of the water constantly skimmed, removing sulfur films and oils. This improves gas exchange and aids in boosting oxygen level. Water evaporates, lowering the water level in the tank. A sump will make sure that the water level in the tank remains constant while the water level in the sump lowers with evaporation and rises with the addition of fresh water. The sump is an excellent place to dose chemicals or to add top-off water. This allows the additive to mix before it goes to the tank, adding additional mechanical and chemical filtration like activated carbon and JFO. Keep a stable water level for skimmer so it doesn't overflow. I recommend always going with the largest sump possible to fit under your tank. Check the available space inside your stand and keep some room to house additional equipment like ATO reservoir, chiller, calcium reactor, and any other equipment. Avoid squeezing too much into this area as much as possible, as it is best to leave plenty of room to maneuver around the sump. The sump should be large enough to hold the needed equipment like skimmer and to handle the drainage from the aquarium when the pumps are shut off without overflowing. The sump will always be less than full when the pumps are running. Like display tank, sump can be ready or custom made. If you choose a ready aquarium set, like Red Sea Reefer or Water Box, these aquariums come ready with sump. If you are going to get a ready made sump, there are many nice designs and features built by Trigger Systems, eShops, and many other brands. One of the cool sumps out there is the Marine Depot sumps that are made by Trigger Systems. These attractive high-quality sumps are packed with useful features. In addition, you can custom make your sump, either glass or acrylic, or even you can do it yourself. Some of the features to look for in a sump are sock or cup holder, tube holders or fitting for dosing and top off pipes, prop holders, adjustable water level in skimmer chamber. If your sump don't have some of these features, you can add some of them easily, like tube and prop holders. I am using this innovative marine Aqua Gadget custom cradle. It is a magnetic holder and I like it so far. Try to avoid holders with suction cups and always use magnetic holders. The sump has different sections. These sections are separated with baffles. It will keep the water level stable, which is very important for skimmer to work correctly. A basic sump can have only two sections, a skimmer section and return section, with a bubble trap between the two sections to minimize macro bubble going to the display tank. The return section has a return bump that will push water from the sump back to the tank. In addition, we can have more sections as needed. Many sumps have sock and cup holder at first section, where the water is drained from the display. These are useful to polish the water and trap large size particles before it breaks down. One drawback that if these socks are not cleaned regularly, they will clog and turn into a nitrate factory. I usually use them after water change for a couple of days, then remove them and wash them in washing machine using some bleach and let them dry completely. Another section is refugium. Refugium is a dedicated area to keep copepods and macroalgae in it. Refugium is very helpful in exporting nutrients and a good place for copepods to flourish and multiply. More details about refugium is coming on a future episode. My sump, the 60 gallon dimensions are 40 inches long, 20 inches width and 19 inches high and have four sections. First is the drain section, followed by fuge with ketomorpha. Then a skimmer section that is big enough to hold the skimmer and a couple of media reactors. Then there is a 2-inch bubble trap before the return section where the water is pushed back to the display. For the sump on the new 120 gallon tank, it's a little smaller with 40 inches long, 16 inches wide, and 18 inches height, and only have three sections, drain, skimmer, and return. Thanks again for Robert and Marine Depot for their support. They have a wide range of sumps to choose from all types and sizes. That's it for today. Next week, I'll talk about how the water will circulate between the main display and the sump, and we will do plumbing. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and see you next week.